Dear students, this is Srinivasan, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, SRM, Valiyame Engineering College. Today we are going to discuss about how to construct an ellipse in the engineering drawing subject. So first step, we are going to read the problem and identify what are the given datas. So in this problem, it is clearly given the focus point value from the directrix is equal to 30 mm, and the eccentricity value is given 2 by 3. In some cases they are not given the word directly as ellipse. Construct and curve or construct and special curves by using the following datas. In this, we are going to find whether the curve is to be ellipse or whether the curve is to be a parabola or whether the curve is to be a hyperbola. First, we have to find that one. If the problem is not directly given as ellipse, so how we are going to find? So check the value of eccentricity. This eccentricity value, which is comes less than 1, then it is called as a ellipse. If it is equal to 1, the curve is called as a parabola. If it is the value comes under greater than 1, it is called as a hyperbola. Here the 2 by 3, the value is 0.6, which is less than 1. So this curve is called as ellipse. Okay. Next step, we are going to mark and find the vertex point after drawing the directrix and the focus point in the drawing area. Then we are going to mark the vertex point. Before we are going to mark the vertex point, we have drawn the directrix and the horizontal lines. So first I am going to draw the directrix line. First I am going to draw the directrix line, that is, you are telling us the vertical line is also called as directrix line. It is to be represented as the letter. Here it is D and here it is D dashed. Okay. From this we are going to draw the horizontal line. It's called as x-axis line, which is perpendicular to the directrix line. So I'm going to draw like this. Then I'm going to mark the focus point. The focus point value is given in the problem is 30 from the directrix. So I keep the scale here. I'm going to mark this as 30. To mark as 30, it's gone. So focus point is a focus point. Okay, so I'm marking this dimension without disturbing the drawing. Here I'm going to mark as 30, which is given in the problem. Okay, the arrow mark drawn is to be very important. It's a box type arrow mark. Then after that, we are going to draw the vertex point. How we are going to draw the vertex point in the drawing? By using of the focus point and the eccentricity value, we are going to easily find the vertex point where it is exactly come. So vertex point is to be represented as a V, which is equal to focus value 30 divided by number of divisions in the eccentricity, that is 2 plus 3, so 30 divided by 5, so which is equal to 6 mm. Okay, 6 mm. So from the directrix to the focus value of 30 mm, which is divided into 5 divisions, because the eccentricity value is given as a 2 by 3. Just add this 2 plus 3, 5. So we are going to split the 30 mm into 5 divisions, but we must consider simultaneously that 5 divisions, we are splitting that 5 divisions in equal distance, so that only we are going to calculate the distance between each divisions. So it is 6 mm. So I'm going to mark here 6 mm, 6 mm, 6 mm, 30. 6 mm, next 6 mm, 6 mm, 6 and 6. So 5 divisions I split. So consider as the denominator value. What is the denominator value is given in the eccentricity? So E equal to 2 by 3. This is the denominator value. What is meant by eccentricity? Eccentricity is the ratio between the moving point from the focus divided by the moving point from the directrix. So that only I have to consider as the denominator value. I am going to mark the vertex point from the directrix itself. So from here, this is a directrix. 1, 2 and 3rd division, okay, it is V. Based on this, we are going to mark the value of V and draw the light line as compared to directrix and the horizontal line, okay, because we must differentiate the lines, okay. So I draw the line, light line as compared, you see here, it is the variations will be shown between these two lines are darkened, directrix and horizontal line is a darkened, and vertex line is I am going to draw very light line. Next step, we are going to make an arc V as the center point, okay, V as the center point, and take the value VF and make an arc, slight arc, okay, make an arc okay, so that is V as the center and take the distance as F, make arc in up direction and the down direction. It is intersect to the vertex line here. So V as the center, I repeat, V as the center and take the measurement values. F is here and make the arc and downward direction. And here one intersection, then another one intersection. You have to mark as the letter R. And here it is R dashed. And give here, it is intersection line between the directrix and the horizontal line. I am giving the letter as A. Next step, I am going to join this AR with the light lines. Okay, so difference between this dark line and light line is very important. Then only the drawing will be coming very neatly. So AR, okay, from through AR, I draw the one line, inclined line, okay, I draw the inclined line, just lighter line, and similar procedure is to be repeated in the downward direction, A and R dashed line. So here, okay, after this we are going to mark vertex point, focus point and R dashed A directrix. Okay, these to be drawn based on the given data which is provided here. Next step, you have to take for the 10 mm difference between the lines, that is after the vertex point I am going to mark the number of lines which is parallel to the vertex line with the dimension of 10 mm. I am noting here 10 mm. Here it is 10. 10. It is common. If you are not interested to take 10 mm, you have to take the line is 5 mm difference between the lines after the vertex line. But in this drawing, I am going to take as 10 mm after the vertex line. So I draw the lines which I measured, but intersecting with the inclined lines. Okay, so I am going to stop up to this. I drawn here. It's a procedure. The line is to be a parallel line with each other. The line is parallel to each other. So this procedure you have to repeat. You see here, I am drawing the light lines.